I'd like to hear some of the songs that Bob Dylan's made up, because of all the people I've heard in America, he seems to be the most prolific. Bob, do you make a song before breakfast every day or before supper?
No, I don't make up a song like that. In fact, sometimes I could go about 2 weeks without making up a song.
I don't believe it.
Oh, yeah. But then sometimes, well, these are the songs that I sing. I might go without 2 weeks and make them up. But I write a lot of stuff. In fact, I wrote 5 songs last night. But I gave all the papers away someplace. It was in a place called Bitter End. And somewhere just about what was happening on the stage. And I would never sing them any place. They were just for myself and for some other people. They might say, write a song about that, and I'd do it. But I don't sit around and do it with the newspapers like a lot of people do, spread newspapers all around and pick something out to write a song about. It's usually right there in my head before I start. That's the way I write it. I mean, it might be a bad approach. But I don't even consider even writing songs. I don't even consider that I wrote it when I got done.
Put it together.
You made
yeah,
it up.
Yeah, I just figure that I made it up or got it someplace. I just sort of... The song was there before me, before I came along. I just sort of came down and just sort of took it down with a pencil, but it was all there before I came around. That's the way I feel about it.
I feel about Bob Dylan's songs very often, that Bob is actually a kind of folk mind. You know, it represents all the people around, and all the ideas current just filter down, and they come out in poetry. And, for example, like one song you wrote about that fellow that has to be put into an institution. What was his name, White?
Oh, yeah, no, he's dead now.
He's dead now. Yeah. For example, you put in one line, you say, the institutions were overcrowded.
Yeah.
And I just couldn't see that appearing in a traditional ballad stanza before you sang it. And it's actually the first song I can think of, a modern song that uses the ideas of the 20th century, Freudian psychology, and the ideas of people being afraid of life in actually a folk song.
Instead of talking about it, let's hear it.
Yeah, can we hear that song?
Let him get tuned up while we're talking anyway, and we can let him give us an example of how these songs just sort of come to him and flow through him.
Well, I think this particular song is historical in the sense that it's the first psychological song of the modern generation that I've heard.
I took this from Bonnie Dobson's tune, Peter Amberley, I think the name of it is. What you see, I stand before you all. I was judged by you a murderer, the hangman's knife must fall. I will die upon the gallows pole when the moon is bright and clear. And these are my final words that you will ever hear. If I had some education to give me a decent start, I might have been a doctor or a master in the arts. But I used my hands for stealing when I was very young, and they locked me down in jailhouse cells. That's how my life begun. And the prisoners, I found they were my kind. It was there inside the bars I found my peace of mind. But the jails, they were too crowded, institutions overflowed. So they set me loose to walk upon life's weary tangled road. And there's danger on the ocean where the salt sea waves split high. And there's danger on the battlefield where the shells of bullets fly. And there's danger in this open world where men fight to be free. And for me, the greatest danger was in society. They said they were too crowded for me, they had no
I got down on my knees and begged, oh please put me away. But they would not listen to my plea or nothing I would say. And so it was on Christmas Eve in the year of 59. It was on that night I killed a man I did not try to hide. The jury found me guilty, and I don't disagree. For I knew that it would happen if I wasn't put away. But I'm glad I've had no parents to care for me and cry. Oh, now they will never know the horrible death that I died. And I'm also glad I've had no friends to see me in disgrace. For they'll never see that hangman's hood wrap around my face. Farewell to the old north woods of which I used to roam. Farewell to the crowded bars of which has been my home. Farewell to all you people that think the worst of me. I guess you'll feel much better when I'm on that hanging tree. But there's just one more question before they kill me dead. I'm wondering just how much to you I really said. Concerning all the boys that walk a road just like me. Are they enemies or victims of your society?
Thank you, Bob Dylan.
I'd like to hear Bob sing another one of his songs.
Okay.
He's got a whole batch of them. Bob, where were you raised?
Gallup, New Mexico, South Dakota.
Holy mackerel. That's where you can go farther and see less than anywhere else.
What do you want to hear? You want to hear anything? I could sing that Emmett Till one, I suppose. That's not in Broadside, though.
Yeah, that's the one you've been promising to Broadside for.
If you will.
Okay. This is Len Chandler's tune. The funny thing about it was that Len is this fellow that plays. You met Len. When he plays and sings, he uses a lot of chords, but he's really good. You know, and he can really get things all kinds of, use his fingers all over, but he's good. He's been always trying to tell me to use more chords and sing a couple songs in minor keys. Before I met him, I never sang one song in minor key. He taught me these chords, he was singing the song to these chords. I saw him do the chords, I stole it from him. He heard me doing it last night. He was out of town. Didn't care, though. So long ago, when a young boy from Chicago town walked through a southern door, this boy's fateful tragedy you should all remember well. The color of his skin was black, and his name was Emmett Till. Some men they dragged him to a barn, and there they beat him up. They said they had a reason, but I disremember what. They tortured him and did some things too evil to repeat. There were screaming sounds in
rolled his body down a gulf amidst a blood red rain, and they threw him in the waters wide to cease his screaming pain. The reason that they killed him there, and I'm sure it ain't no lie, was just for the fun of killing him and to slowly watch him die. And then to stop the United States of yelling for a trial, two brothers, they confessed that they had killed poor Emmett Till. But on the jury, there were men who helped the brothers commit this awful crime. And so this trial was a mockery, but nobody seemed to mind. I saw the morning papers, but I could not bear to see the smiling brothers walking down the courthouse stairs. For the jury found them innocent, and the brothers, they went free. While Emmett's body floats a foam of a Jim Crow southern sea. If you can't speak out against this kind of thing, a crime that's so unjust, your eyes are filled with dead man's dirt, and your mind is filled with dust. Your arms and legs, they must be in shackles and chains, and your blood, it must refuse to flow for you to let this human race fall down so god-awful. This song is just a reminder to remind your fellow man that this kind of thing still lives today in that ghost group of Ku Klux Klan. But if all us folks that thinks alike, if we'd give all we could give, we'd make this great land of ours a greater place to live.
Topical songs have been the topic of the program this afternoon. We just about reached the end of the program, and I'd like Bob Dylan to sing the last song called "The Answer Is Blown in the Wind." And I'm sorry?
He's going to sing it. Oh, is "The Answer Is Blown in the Wind"?
Yeah.
That one. Oh, okay.
Yeah, because I think this song, and while being a topical song, is just filled with poetry that people of all kinds can enjoy.
The answer is blown in the wind.
Bob Dylan, Gil Turner, Pete Seeger, Sis Cunningham, and myself, Israel Young.
Put a nickel or a quart, gonna look in your money bag and find your 1 cent short. Hey, hey, I sure hate to be you on that dreadful day. The clock is gonna stop on St. Peter's Gate. You're gonna ask him what time it is. He's gonna say too late. Hey, hey, I sure hate to be you on that dreadful day. You're gonna walk naked. You can't ride in no car. Everybody's gonna see just what you are. Hey, hey. Sure hate to be you on that dreadful day. Oxford town, Oxford town, everybody's got the head bowed down. Sun don't shine above the ground, ain't it going down to Oxford town? He went down to Oxford town, guns and clubs followed him down, all because his face was brown. Better get away from Oxford town. Oxford town around the bend, he come to the door, he couldn't get in, all because of the color of his skin. What do you think about that, my friend? Me, my gal, son, we got met with a tear gas bomb. I don't even know why we come, going back where we come from. Oxford town in the afternoon, everybody singing a sorrowful tune. Two men died neath the Mississippi moon, somebody better investigate soon.
Track.
There's a one-way wind a-blowing, it was a-blowing at my back. Trails of trouble, roads of battle, paths of victory, we shall walk. The road, it might be dusty, it might sometimes get rough, but the good road is waiting, and boys, it ain't far off. Trails of troubles, roads of battles, paths of victory, we shall walk. I went out to the valleys, I turned my head up high, I saw the silver lining that was hanging in the sky. Trails of troubles, roads of battles, paths of victory, we shall walk. Gravel road is calling, it's a hard road to ride. Some old day it'll be better when the cinders are on the side. Days of troubles, roads of battles, paths of victory, we shall walk.
Trouble of mine, I got a heavy head again. Got a heavy head again. I got a heavy head again. She ain't feeling well, and she's better, only time will tell. Lord, I'm walking down the line. Lord, I'm walking down the line. And I'm walking down the line. My feet'll be fine to tell about my trouble of mine. At the break of dawn. At the break of dawn. At the break of dawn, I've suddenly gone. I'm up and down in Washington. Lord, I'm walking down the line. And I'm walking down the line. Lord, I'm walking down the line. My feet'll be a pine to tell about my trouble of mine. My money comes and goes. My money comes and goes. My money comes and goes. It runs and flows through the holes in the pockets of my clothes. As I'm walking down the line. And I'm walking down the line. Lord, I'm walking down the line. My feet'll be fine to tell about my trouble of mine. I saw the morning light. I saw the morning light. I saw the morning because I'm an early riser. I didn't go to sleep last night. Lord, I'm walking down the line. Lord, I'm walking down the line. And I'm walking down the line. Feet a bit fine to tell about my trouble of mine. Cold prison walls can't change my mind.
my mind, can't change my mind. Your cold prison walls can't change my mind. Not now or no other time. The laughter in the lynch mob ain't gonna do no more. Ain't gonna do no more. Ain't gonna do no more. The laughter in the lynch mob ain't gonna do no more. Not now or no other time. All free taking money makers can't get me down, can't get me down, can't get me down. You free taking money makers can't get me down, not now or no other time. Oh, you red baiters and race haters, guide my road, can't guide my road, can't guide my road. You red baiters and race haters, can't guide my road. Not now or no other time. Your Jim Crow ground can't turn me around, can't turn me around. Oh, your Jim Crow ground can't turn me around. Not now or no other time. The playboys and playgirls ain't gonna run my world. Ain't gonna run my world. Ain't gonna run my world. All the playboys and playgirls ain't gonna run my world, not now or no other time. Two Fallout Shelter sellers can't get in my door, can't get in my door, can't get in my door. Two Fallout Shelter sellers can't get in my door. Not now or no other time. Your Jim Crow ground.
This is all about where the devil is. Some people say that there's no devil. Well, sometimes you can't see him so good when he hides his head and eats a snow-eyed hood and rides to kill with his face well hid and then goes home to his wife and kids. I wonder if his kids know who he is. Well, he wants you to hate, he wants you to fear, he wants you to fear something that's not even there. He'll give you your hate, he'll give you his lies, he'll give you the weapons to run out and die, and you'll give him your soul.
So it's fairly well, my own time as I'm rambling, you can travel with me too. With my head, my heart, and my hands, my love, I will send what I know back home to you. So it's very well, my own true love. Give me another day, another time. It's not the leaving that's the grief in me, but my darling to found stay behind. I will tell you of troubles and of laughter, be it somebody else's or my own. With my hands in my pocket and my coat collar high, I will travel unnoticed and unknown. So it's farewell, my own true love. We'll meet another day, another time. It's not the leaving that's a grief.
Masters of war, you that build all the guns, you that build the death planes, you that build the big bombs, you that hide behind walls, you that hide behind discs, I just want you to know I can see through your mask. You that never done nothing but build to destroy. You play with my world like it's your little toy. You put a gun in my hand, then you hide from my eyes. And you turn and run farther when the fast bullets fly. Like Judas of old, you lie and deceive. A world war can be won. You want me to believe, but I see through your eyes, and I see through your brain. I see through the water that runs down my drain. Passing the triggers for the others to fire. Then you sit back and watch while the death count gets higher. You hide in your mansion while the young people's blood flows out of their bodies and is buried in the mud. How much do I know to speak out of turn? You might say that I'm young. You might say I'm unlearned. But there's the one thing I know. Though I'm younger than you, that even Jesus would never forgive what you do. Let me ask you one question. Is your money that good? Will it buy you forgiveness? Do you think that it could? I think you will find when your death takes its toll that all the money you made don't ever buy back your soul. I hope that you die, and your death will come soon. I'll follow your casket by the pale afternoon, and I'll walk. watch while you load down to your deathbed. And I stand over your grave till I'm sure that you're dead.
Because someone tells me that death's coming around, I will not carry myself down to die. If I die, let me die with my head held high. Let me die in my footsteps before I'll go down under the ground. There's been rumors of wars, wars that have been. The meaning of life has been lost in the wind. Some people are thinking that the end is close by. Instead of learning to live, they are learning to die. Let me die in my footsteps before I go down under the ground. Well, I don't know if I'm smart, but I think I can see when someone is pulling the wool over me. And if there's a war and death comes around, let me die on this earth, for I'll die underground. Let me die in my footsteps before I go down under the ground. Now there's always been people that have cause to fear. They've been talking about wars for many a long year. I've read all their statements, I've not said a word. But now, Lord God, let my poor voice be heard. Let me die in my footsteps before I go down under the ground. If I had riches and rubies and crowns, I'd buy the whole world and I'd change things around. I'd throw all the tanks and the guns in the sea, for they're the mistakes of our past history. Let me die in my footsteps before I go down under the ground. Let me drink from the waters where the mountain streams flood. Let the smell of wild flowers flow free through my blood. Let me sleep in the meadows with your green grassy leaves. Let me walk down the highway with my brothers in peace. Let me die in my footsteps before I go down under the ground. Go out in the country where the land meets the sun. See the craters and the canyons and the wild waters run. Nevada, New Mexico, Arizona, Idaho. Let every state in the Union sink deep in your soul. Then you'll die in your footsteps before you go down under the ground.
As I was out walking on a corner one day, I spied an old hobo in the doorway he lay. His face was all grounded in the cold sidewalk floor, and I guess he'd been dead for the whole night or more. Only a hobo, but one more is gone, leaving nobody to sing his sad song. Leaving nobody to carry him home. He was only a hobo, but one more is gone. A blanket of newspaper covered his head. As a step was his pillow, the street was his bed. One look at his face showed the hard road he'd come. A fistful of coins showed the money he bombed. He was only a hobo, but one more is gone, leaving nobody to sing his sad song, leaving nobody to carry him home. He was only a hobo, but one more is gone. Does it take much of a man to see his whole life go down, to look up in the world from a hole in the ground, to wait for your future like a horse that's gone lame, to lie in the gutter and to die with no name? He was only a hobo, but one more is gone, leaving nobody to sing his sad song, leaving nobody to carry him home. He was only a hobo, but one more is gone. John Brown went off to war to fight on a foreign shore. His mother sure is proud of him. He stood so straight and tall in his uniform and all. His mother's face broke out all in a grin. Oh, son, you look so fine. I'm glad you're a son of mine. You make me proud to know you hold a gun. Do what the captain says, lots of medals you will get, and we'll put them on the wall when you come home. When that old train pulled out, John's ma began to shout, telling everyone in the neighborhood, that's my son that's about to go, he's a soldier now, you know. She made well sure her neighbors understood. She got a letter once in a while, and her face broke into a smile as she showed them from to the people from next door. And she bragged about her son with his uniform and gun in this thing she called a good old-fashioned war. Lord, Lord, good old-fashioned war. And the letters ceased to come for a long time. They did not come. They ceased to come for about 9 months or more. Then a letter finally came saying, go down and meet the train. Your sons are coming home from the war. She smiled and went right down. She looked up and all around, but she did not see her soldier son in sight. But as all the people passed, she saw her son at last. When she did, she could hardly believe her eyes. His face was all shot up, and his hands were both blown off, and he wore a metal brace around his waist. He whispered kind of slow in a voice she did not know, while she could not even recognize his face. Oh, tell me, my darling son, pray tell me what they've done. How is it that you've come to be this way? He tried his best to talk as his mouth could hardly move, and his mother had to turn her head away. Don't you remember, Ma, when I went off to war? You thought it was the best thing I could do. I was on the battleground, you were home acting proud. Gee, thank God you wasn't standing in my shoes. Lord, I thought when I was there, God, what am I doing here? I'm trying to kill somebody or die trying. But the thing that scared me most is when my enemy came close and I saw that his face looked just like mine. Lord, Lord, just like mine. And through, and I could not help but think, through the thunder rolling stink, that I was just a puppet in a play. And through the roaring smoke, the string had finally broke, and a cannonball, it blew my eyes away. As he turned away to walk, his ma was still in shock, seeing the metal brace that helped him stand. But as he turned to go, He called his mother close, and he dropped his medals down into her hand. Lord, Lord, down to her hand.
Like a duck, I smell like a skunk. But it don't matter to me, it don't hurt my pride. Got my little lady right by my side. Pretending she don't know me.
Well, late last night, I was with me one. Late last night, I was three-fourths tight. She looked half right. Tail, she took off her face, put it on a book, took off her wig, says, how do I look? I was high flying, out the window, bare naked. Well, funniest girl I ever seen, great granddaughter of Mr. Clean. Takes 10 million baths a day, wants me to grow a mustache on my face. She's insane. Well, I sat down on a television floor, flicked the number, channel 4. Out of the shower came a football man with a bottle of greasy in his hand. Greasy kid stuff. Well, I want to know is what you're going to do about Willie Mays, Martin Luther King, Ola Tunji. Well, man on the stand, he wants my vote. He's running for office on a ballot note. Standing, preaching in front of the steeple, telling me he loves all kinds of people. He's eating bagels. Pizza, he's eating chitlins. Well, ain't no use me working all the time. I got a woman who works so blind. She works up to her britches, up to her neck, writes my letters and sends my checks. She's a humdinger, folk singer. Kennedy called me up. He said, what do we need to make the country grow? I thought for a minute and said, man, Bridget Bardot, Sophia Loren, Nina Ekberg, Woodrow.
Train of traveling, red and rolling through the air, with a firebox of hatred and a furnace full of fears. If you've ever heard it sound or seen, it's a blood red broken frame. And you know my voice, and you heard my name. Have you ever stopped and wondered about the hatred that it holds? Have you ever seen its passengers, its crazy mixed up souls? Do you ever start thinking that you gotta stop the train? And you know my voice and you heard my name. Have you ever had it on your lips or said it in your head? That the person standing next to you just might be misled. Have you ever looked around and been confused with what you've seen? And you know my voice and you've heard my name.
It's a whole song. It's got. I can't think of the rest. No, that's not the next one. That's in there though. I'm joking. I sing a few words. I didn't memorize this yet. I'm gonna change it anyway. People, and a story I will tell. I remember that long ago, you all remember well. I'll tell it to you straight and true. I'll tell it like your friend. All about the fearful night we fought the world in. I was walking down the sidewalk, not causing any harm. The radio reported it sounded with alarm. Russian ships were sailing all out across the sea. We all feared by daybreak it'd be World War number three. I thought about an argument I'd had the day before over some small matter. I'm sure it was nothing more. But just a day ago, how it wrinkled up my brow. Same thing today seems so unimportant now.
Now to introduce a young singer from New York, Bob Dylan.
A bullet from the back of a bush took Medgar Evers' blood. A finger fired the trigger to his name. They had no hit out in the dark. The hand set the spark. Two eyes took the aim. Man's brain, but he can't be blamed. He's only a pawn in their game. He's
Mr. Floyd McKissick, National Chairman of Congress of Racial Equality. He is speaking instead of our good friend and brother, James Farmer, who is now in prison in Laquiman, Louisiana. We all give up our prayers in behalf of our brother, Jim Farmer. We will now hear from Brother McKissick.
The message that I shall give to you today was written by Jim Farmer from a Plaquemine jail. And I shall quote his message now.
Act with valor and dignity and act without fear.
Some of us may die, like William L. Moore or Medgar Evers, but our war is for life, not for death, and we will not stop our demand for freedom now. We will not slow down. We will not stop our militant, peaceful demonstrations. We will not come off of the streets until we can work at a job befitting of our skills in any place in the land.
The military policemen here are certainly having a difficult time holding the crowd behind the fence in front of the Lincoln Memorial. We return now to Philip Randolph.
Violent Coordinating Committee, Brother John Lewis.
We are tired of being beaten by policemen. We're tired of seeing our people locked up in jail over and over again. And then you holler, be patient. How long can we be patient? We want our freedom, and we want it now.
We do not want to go to jail,
but we will go to jail if this is the price we must pay for love, brotherhood, and true peace. I appeal to all of you to get in this great revolution that is sweeping this nation. Get in and stay in the streets of every city, every village and hamlet of this nation until true freedom comes, until the revolution of 1776 is complete. We must get in this revolution and complete the revolution. For in the Delta of Mississippi, in Southwest Georgia, in the Black Belt of Alabama, in Harlem, in Chicago, Detroit, Philadelphia, and all over this nation, the black mass is on the march for jobs and freedom.
But it ain't him to blame. He's only a pawn in their game. The day Medgar Evers was buried from the bullet that he caught, they lured him down as a king. But when the shadowy sun sets on the one that fired the gun, he'll see by his grave on the stone that remains, right next to his name, his epitaph plain. Only a pawn in their game.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've been asked by the Chief Marshal to ask you, please, those who are standing in the back, not to press so hard on those who are in front against the fences. Thank you. I would like now to introduce a young singer from New York, Bob Dylan.
A bullet from the back of a bush took Medgar Evers' blood. His finger fries, he triggered his name. Hey, hey, so hit out in the dark. The hand set the spark. Two eyes took the aim. Behind a man's brain. But he came to claim. He's only a pawn in their game. The South politician preaches to the poor white man. You got more than the black, don't complain. You're rises to fame, and the poor white remains on the caboose of the train. But it ain't him to blame, he's only a pawn in their game. The deputy sheriff, the soldiers, the governors get paid, and the marshals and cops get the same. But the poor white man's used in the hands of them all like a tool. He's caught in his school from the start by the rule that the laws are with him to protect his white skin, to keep up his heat, so he never thinks straight about the shape that he's in. So it ain't him to blame, he's only a pawn in their game. From the poverty shack, he looks from the cracks to the track, and the hoofbeats pound in his brain, and he's told how to walk in a pack, shoot in the back with his fist in a clinch, to hang and to clinch, to hide neath a hood, to kill with no pain, like a dog on a chain. He ain't got no name, but it ain't him to blame, he's only a pawn in their game. The dame Edgar Evers was buried from the bullet that he caught. They lowered him down as a king, but when the shadowy sun sets on the one that fired the gun, he'll see by his grave on the stone that remains, carved next to his name, his epitaph plain, only a pawn in their game.
We will bring this will be our final selection from the folk singing group, and we ask that all of you within the sound of their voices join in and express your feelings. This is Joan Baez, Bob Dylan, Lynn Chandler, and others, and a song of their own.
I read it in the paper the other day. Things are swinging in the USA. Keep your eyes on the prize. Hold on. Let me hear you now. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Hold on. I want to tell you so you know. I'm building a coffin for old Jim Crow. Keep your eyes on the prize. Hold on.
Keep your eyes on the prize.